Emma is from Sydney, Australia. She's a psychologist and a coach. Give her a big round of applause.
Hello. How are you?
So as a coaching psychologist, I work with clients who are very educated, capable, powerful individuals. They're often in senior levels of their organizations or in business. But like everybody, they go through challenging times, both professionally and personally. So they come to me to help make sense of all of that. Now, you've been through some challenges in business and personally, and you're also a very accomplished businesswoman. So what would be two pieces of advice that you would give my clients as to how to handle those times?
How to handle the challenges, you're saying?
Those challenging times that just come up for all of us at some point, whether it's personal.
I mean, everybody has a bad childhood, everybody has challenging times. If your parents are together, you know, they fought in another room and you heard it and you didn't know what was going on. If you were personally abused and your parents were apart, you know, everybody has challenging times. So I think it, just knowing that is comforting. I think I really value sleep more than most things. I think when you know you're in a bad road, like if it's a bad divorce or a bad financial situation or somebody's sick or something, you have to set yourself up for as much success as possible. For me, that would mean, okay, during this time, or let's say, God forbid, you break an ankle or something, you have to be home. Like, instead of leaning into it and getting depressed and just eating junk food in a stressful time, I'll say, let me try to make something positive out of this. Let me try to, like, eat really healthy because I know that I'm going to be laying in bed. Or if I know that I'm going through a terrible, terrible divorce, let's make this not the time that I do what I would like to do, which is go out and, like, live in a bottle of vodka. Let's make this a time to, like, sleep more, because you can't be sane if you're not sleeping. So I think sort of mitigate damages and just live in the moment where you know. I think of things like a golf game or a marathon. Like when I was going through my divorce, which it's never ending, but I think I'm at the fourth hole now. And then you get to the 12th hole and then you might get back. You know, I think if you think of it like that, you're not gonna be so, it's not so daunting to think about, oh my God, I have to get through 18 holes of this or 26 miles. So I like to think of it as like benchmarks. It's mentally helpful to just breathe and be like, this is this moment right now and I'm okay right now. I'm healthy, I'm alive, you know, everything. I love my daughter, she loves me, we're good, we're safe. And then tomorrow's another thing. Rather than like, and the same thing, it could be like cleaning out your basement, which is like, you know, versus just like, let me take this one corner of the basement. I think it's easy to attack things piece by piece.
Absolutely. Thank you so much.